In May of 1999, a troubled 14-year-old girl walked into a Hong Kong police station with a haunting story. She was visibly distressed, and as she sat there, she began to share her unsettling belief that she was being haunted by the spirit of a lady who had been tortured to death while tied to an electrical wire. Since the police obviously don't handle paranormal matters, they still listened patiently as the girl shared her distressing experiences. She described encountering a recurring spirit, a young woman in her 20s, whose presence haunted her every night. The girl told the police that the ghostly woman she saw was always covered in blood, and she thought that by telling the police, she could make these scary nightly encounters stop. The police's curiosity was heightened, however, when she revealed that the spirit was of a lady she had helped kill. The teenage girl confessed to being involved in this gruesome crime that lasted a month, where they tortured and murdered a young woman in her 20s. According to her, the spirit she saw was the angry ghost of the victim, haunting her until she confessed her sins. The identity of this teenage girl has been kept confidential throughout the case, and her true name remains unknown. While she was 14 when she went to the police station to share her story, she had actually been only 13 at the time when she participated in the crime. Importantly, she was not acting alone in this terrible act. She was indeed part of a group that committed this horrific crime against the woman. However, she stood out as the youngest member and the only female in the group. Others involved were older men in their 20s and 30s who were known for their influence and ties with the Triad, which is basically the Chinese mafia. She sat and told cops that it was mostly all of the men who were causing this to happen to the woman, and she showed up on occasion. One of these older men was her boyfriend. She was 13 years old, and her boyfriend was 34. Before going deeper into the story, let's go back to the beginning to understand everything better. Let's start with our victim, Fan Man Yi. Fan Man Yi was 23 years old, and by sources, it is said that she was a nightclub hostess. Born in 1976 in Shenzhen, Fan Man Yi experienced a turbulent and challenging upbringing. Abandoned by her family during her childhood, she found herself in the care of an all-girls orphanage in Ma Tau Wai. However, when she reached the age of 15, she was asked to leave due to age restrictions, leaving her without a stable home. Struggling with homelessness and grappling with drug addiction, Fan was forced into a life of street prostitution, a grim reality she endured until the age of 21. In 1996, her life took a different turn when she married one of her clients, Ing Chi Yuan, who was also battling drug addiction. Not long after, in approximately November 1998, Fan gave birth to their son. The family lived in Mong Kok, Hong Kong, until the tragic events that led to her murder unfolded. Fan's husband was described as abusive, and neighbors would report being woken up by the sounds of the couple's fights and the child screaming and crying from their apartment. When she found out she was pregnant and later gave birth to her son, Fan decided to make a change in her life. She was determined to protect her child and provide him with a safer and more stable upbringing. As a result, she made the courageous decision to break free from her drug addiction and leave behind her life as a prostitute. Fan secured employment as a hostess at a nightclub called Empress Karaoke Club, signaling her commitment to leaving her turbulent past behind. Ultimately, she found the strength to leave her abusive husband shortly before her tragic murder. However, now she had a much lower income and struggled to support herself and her family. In the early months of 1997, Fan Man Yi crossed paths with Chan Manlock, a 34-year-old socialite, during her time at the nightclub. Interestingly, they found a common thread in their lives. Fan Man Yi, once a prostitute and drug addict, and Chan Manlock, a pimp and drug dealer. Before too long, Fan Man Yi became a frequent member of Chan Manlock's group, which consisted not only of him but also his associates and henchmen. Was Xing Wei Triad member, known for his troublesome behavior dating back to his middle school years and with prior convictions for drug trafficking in 1991, was among Fan's frequent clients at the brothel where she worked. Later in 1997, driven by desperation for both money and drugs, Fan Man Yi made a fateful decision. She stole Chan Manlock's wallet, hoping to secure the 4,000 Hong Kong dollars it contained, which in American dollars would be approximately equivalent to $520 US. However, she was unaware that John Manlock was the last person she should have stolen from, setting in motion a series of tragic events. When John Manlock realized that his money had disappeared, he reacted immediately in anger. John confronted her with a demand that extended beyond the return of the stolen money. He not only insisted on the immediate return of the stolen money, but also demanded an additional compensatory fee of 10,000 Hong Kong dollars. Fan quickly gave back the money she had taken, but she was unable to meet the upfront demand for the additional amount. On March 17, 1999, a terrifying incident happened as Fan was forcibly taken from her residence in the Fuyu section of Liu Estate. The perpetrators of this abduction included Chan, who was at the center of this tragedy. His grooming victim Lau Mingfang, known as Ah Fang, the 14-year-old girl, Liang Wailuan, referred to as Gangsta 1, and Liang Xingqiu, known as Gangsta 2, the boyfriend of Lau. The group transported Fan to an apartment located at number 31 Granville Road in Sim Sha Sui. This apartment was rented by Chan himself, but it was owned by two individuals named Ah Sam and Ah Cao, who were not associated with criminal activities. Initially, Chan's sinister plan was to force her into working as a prostitute for his benefit, making sure that the money she earned would serve as payback for the sum she had taken from him. During her month-long captivity, Fan went through unimaginable suffering. She was beaten with metal bars, sometimes while hanging up, and was even treated like a punching bag. One time, she was kicked in the head about 50 times. Her tormentors also hurt her in other terrible ways, like rubbing spices into her wounds and burning her legs and feet with hot wax and plastic, which made it hard for her to walk. What's even more horrifying is that they forced her to eat things like human waste and drink urine. They made her pretend to be happy, smiling and saying she liked being beaten. If she refused, they would hurt her even more. After a month of being hurt, sometime between April 14th and 15th, Ah Fang found out that Fan Manyi had died during the night. Chan Manlock and his group argued that she had taken too much methamphetamine and died by herself, but many experts think it was her injuries that caused her death. It's hard to be sure. Once they realized she was dead, the group moved her body to the bathtub in the apartment and used a saw to cut her into pieces. Then, they did something very disturbing. They cooked the parts of her body to stop it from smelling bad as it rotted. They used the same stove where they cooked their meals to boil her body parts, and then they threw them away with the regular household garbage, trying to hide the terrible evidence of their crime. Her skull had been sewn inside a Hello Kitty doll, which was filled with dead insects. Unfortunately, the rest of her body had been discarded and lost. Only a few parts of Fan's remains were discovered later on. These included her skull, some internal organs, and one tooth, all found inside a plastic bag. The discovery was made when Lau, one of the individuals involved, led the Almaty police to the location on May 24th. Three police officers, namely Chiu Kashu, Sin Timhua, and Andrew Yip Yen Ling from the Almaty Police Division No. 539, were the first to arrive at the scene. Other parts of Fan's body were found in different trash dumps located in Sham Shui Pa, Wan Chai, and Tai Kok Sui. Upon discovering that news of the murder had reached the media through a local newspaper based in Macau, Liang Wailuan decided to flee to mainland China, specifically Guangxi. However, his escape was short-lived as police apprehended him on February 14, 2000, after detecting irregularities in his passport. Before his arrest, he had been placed on Interpol's list of most wanted individuals. Liang was subsequently returned to Hong Kong on February 17 to face trial. On December 7, 2000, following a trial that had started on October 20 of the same year, the three men were found guilty of manslaughter by a jury with a vote of 6-3. The 14-year-old girl, Lau, testified during the trial in exchange for immunity. Justice Peter Nguyen, who took over the case, sentenced the trio to life imprisonment with the possibility of parole. He stated, "Never in Hong Kong in recent years has a court heard of such cruelty, depravity, callousness, brutality, violence, and viciousness." Psychiatric assessments from Castle Peak Hospital and Shu Lam Hospital characterized the three men as remorseless. The possibility of parole would not be considered for at least 20 years, with the earliest opportunity being in 2020. Currently, John Manlock and Leon Wailuan are serving their life sentences in Stanley Prison. The identification of Fan's skull was finally made on June 3rd, using a photo overlapping method at Lockhart Mortuary. Following this, the skull was transferred to Kowloon Public Mortuary after the conclusion of the trial. In March 2004, the authorities informed Fan Manny's birth family that the skull would be returned to them. It was scheduled to be cremated on March 26th, marking the conclusion of this grim chapter in the case. And this is the end of the Hello Kitty case. If you are interested for more intriguing crime cases, follow and stay tuned for more mysteries that will keep you on the edge of your seat.